I need to make about 120 of these parts. Except the master that I was given was a solid piece. I'm going to show you how I converted that solid into a thin-walled part using a weep mold. My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making. I hope that you like, enjoy, and become a subscriber. Make sure that you hit that little bell next to the subscribe button too, in case you haven't already done so. That way you'll be notified every time I have a new video. The part on the left is a cast urethane part. The part on the right was the master, the one that I'm holding in my hand. It's a 3D printed solid part. When you're casting parts like this, you want them to be economical, so they need to be thin-walled or hollow on the inside. I'm going to show you how I did that using what I call a weep mold. So we're going to start with the reusable mold boxes that I showed you how to make in the last video. If you haven't seen that, you might want to go back and check that out. Here, I'm just adding the registration markers around the part so that that piece can be put together and taken apart the same way every single time. Mixing up a little bit of silicone that we're going to use to pour the first half of our mold. In it goes after it's been vacuum degassed. You notice I put it all in the corner and let it flow out over the model really slow. This is sped up, of course. It takes a lot longer than that normally. So once the silicone's cured, I'd start taking the mold box apart so that I can take the master out and also take out the registration pins. To do that, I need to finish taking off the sides of the mold box. To convert the solid master model to a thin-walled or hollow part, I need to create some sheet clay. So what I do is I have some rails or guides that I make out of some wood, and I fill in between that with some clay. I'm just using some tools to flatten out the top of the clay. This is an old clay modeling trick, and that's just a spline. Once that I've gotten the clay to the correct thickness, it's basically in sheet form, and I can use these sheet pieces to fill into the mold that you see there on the left. To create the thickness of the part that I want, I would say the pieces are probably about, I don't know, 10 millimeters thick, something like that, quarter of an inch roughly. And I place the clay inside there to give the part my thickness and build that up. And that's what we're going to cast into with the second half of the mold. Now, we need to get the clay flush with the top of the existing mold. So we're going to do the old lasagna trick. We're going to put the mold in the freezer and let it freeze so that the clay gets really hard. It really works best if you put it next to the frozen lasagna, of course. So once it's frozen, you can take it out of the freezer, and the clay is going to be super hard, and you're going to be able to scrape it without smashing and mushing the clay all over the place and get it nice and flat with the top of the mold. Now, the inside of the part, not super critical, but I want to make it kind of halfway decent, and I've kind of scraped it, but it's a little tough to get in the negative shape there of the part. So I'm just going to take a little solvent. In this case, I'm using a little lacquer thinner, and that kind of melts the clay. And I'm going to use a cloth, and I smooth it all out using kind of a quick and dirty method to get it all nice and smooth on the inside. Put the mold back together. We'll start pouring the back half or the second part of the mold. You can see the sprue sticking up there that's already been cast. And then those little white spokes are the weep channels. That's where the resin will weep out of the mold. Here I'm peeling the part apart after it silicone's been cured, and I'm removing the clay. Obviously the clay is where the part will be cast later. I'm finishing the weep cuts, and this shows you how the part is cast. I pour most of the resin in, I pour the top on, put a syringe in the top, and I tip the mold, and I'm able to pour in the rest of the resin. So what happens is that the resin will weep out of those channels, and it will take with it all the air, so I don't have any air bubbles in that top surface, and I can easily just clean them up and package them and give them to my customer. Here's one of the parts, all painted in a beautiful Porsche lime green. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. You can click on the little icon on the bottom right of the screen to do that. You can follow me on Twitter, Facebook, and Google+. Rock on. Click here to watch some of the other design and making videos that I have. If you'd like to have your music featured in one of my videos, drop me a line. We'll be right back.